It is 27 minutes after the hour. Welcome back to the Most News in the Morning. Top stories are just minutes away, but first, in an AM original, something you'll see only on American Morning. We're talking about the filibuster. Oh, yes, it got the name back in the 1850s and has been used for ages. But has it lost its political punch? Jim Acosta joins us with another report in our series, Broken Government. What's going on here, Jim?
Okay, you know, correspondents have been accused of...
effective, a little less exciting, though. Thank you so much, Jim.
A little less, yes.
Thanks so much.
And what fun is a filibuster if you don't have people talking for
I know,
hours
break out the phone book.
Sleeping on cots. Yeah, really. Crossing the half hour, checking this morning's top stories. Three bombings have killed.
The attorney representing Major Nidal Hassan is raising a few eyebrows. He started a blog to air his complaints about the case.
Now, retired Army Colonel John Galligan says he is under a gag order. So does blogging violate that, and should it even be allowed? Joining us now is Paul Callan, a professor. You've sort of changed your mind on this a little bit. Yesterday, you were thinking that it was a bad idea to do what he was doing, but you talked to some folks today and say, well, maybe there's actually a strategy here.
Well, you know, I had an interesting discussion this morning with an expert, a JAG officer, Lieutenant.
Started this blog, FortHoodAttorney.com, to vent his anger about the gag order. But by doing that, is he in violation of the gag order?
Well, I think technically...
today, and I was somewhat intrigued to find out that anytime he mentions President Obama, he calls him Barack Hussein Obama. And then I read through some of the comments as well, and people do not seem to be very sympathetic to the things that he's saying in the overall. Leslie, who was one of the commenters, wrote, quote, here's a thought, let's have attorney. Could potentially taint a jury pool, but what about a military jury? Are
well,
they immune
yes.
to it?
No, no. The same. Once this here is that.
Yeah, we remember that guy, Bill Cunningham, was that his name that got thrown under the bus by.
You bet. The McCain you bet. Campaign. And Galligan. What's odd here is Galligan's representing a Muslim client.
The chances could this backfire on him and his client?
Well, it could backfire because if the case remains. Well, the advantage of the civilian system is nice to be here, Jim.
Thanks so much, Paul.
Staying with the military, the relationship between the military and Hollywood.